Was lost in sin, but Jesus took me in. And then a little light from heaven filled my soul. It bathed my heart in love and wrote my name above. And just a little talk with Jesus makes me whole.
Now let us
have a little talk. Jesus,
let us
tell him all about our troubles.
He will
hear our faintest cry
and we
answer by and
by.
Feel a little prayer will turn
you will know
a little fire's burning. Find a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
I may have doubts and fears, my eyes be filled with tears, but Jesus is a friend who watches day and night. I go to him and pray, he knows my every care, and just a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
Have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about our troubles.
He will
hear our faintest cry.
He will
answer by and
by.
Feel a little prayer will
tell you we
know a little fire is burning. Find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Find a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
Find a little talk with Jesus.
Find a little talk with Jesus.
just makes it just a little talk with him must be all right.
A call comes ringing o'er the restless waves.
Send the light,
send the light,
send the light,
send the light. There are souls to rescue, there are souls to save.
Send the light,
send the light,
send the light,
send the light.
We will spread,
we will spread
the everlasting light
with the wind,
with the wind,
heart in hand,
heart in hand,
giving God.
Evermore
we will follow,
we will follow
His command.
Send the light,
send the light,
the blessing,
blessing gospel light.
Let it shine,
let it shine,
from shore to shore,
from shore to shore.
Send the light,
send the light,
and let it
radiant, radiant beams
light the world,
light the world,
forevermore,
We have heard the Macedonian call today.
Send the light,
send the light,
send the light,
send the light. And a golden offering at the cross we lay.
Send the light,
send the light,
send the light,
send the light.
We will spread,
we will spread
the everlasting light
with the will,
with the will,
heart in hand,
heart in hand.
Giving God,
giving God
the glory, the glory evermore.
We will
His God,
follow His command.
Send the light,
send the light,
the blessed gospel light.
Let it shine,
let it shine,
from shore to shore,
from shore to shore.
Send the light,
send the light,
and let it shine,
radiant beams
light the world,
light the world,
forevermore.
Let us pray that grace may everywhere abound.
Send the light,
send the light,
send the light,
send the light. And the Christ-like spirit everywhere be found.
Send the light,
send the light,
send the light,
send the light.
We will spread,
we will spread
the everlasting
light
with the will,
with the will,
heart in hand,
heart in hand.
Giving God,
giving God
the glory, glory
evermore.
We will follow,
we will
His
God,
follow His command.
Send the light,
send the light,
the blessed gospel light.
Let it shine,
let it shine,
from shore to shore,
from shore to shore.
Send the light,
send the light,
and let it shine,
radiant beams
light the world,
light the world,
forevermore.
Let us not grow weary in the work of love.
Send the light,
send the light,
send the light,
send the light. Let us gather jewels for a crown above.
Send the light,
send the light,
send the light,
send the light.
We will spread,
we will spread
the everlasting
light
with the will,
with the will,
heart in hand,
heart in hand.
Giving God,
giving God
the glory, glory
evermore.
We will follow,
we will
follow,
follow His command.
Send the light,
send the light,
the blessed gospel light.
Let it shine,
let it shine,
from shore to shore,
from shore to shore.
Send the light,
send the light,
and let it change
your beams
light the world,
light the world,
forevermore.
So sweet as Jesus, no one ever cares so much for me.
blessed to shed his precious blood to save me. No one ever cared so much for me.
When I'll see him face to face, up in glory, I will marvel at his nail-scarred feet.
Nail-scarred feet.
And I'll thank him for the pain he suffered, because
he cared so much for me.
Yeah, 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 y once was lost in sin, but Jesus took me in. And then a little light from heaven filled my soul. It bathed my heart in love and wrote my name above. And just a little talk with Jesus makes me whole.
Now let us
have a little talk with Jesus.
Let us
tell him all about our troubles.
He will
hear our faintest cry. Answer by and by. Feel a little prayer will turn
you. Will know
a little fire's burning. Find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. I may have doubts and fears. My eyes be filled with tears. But Jesus is a friend who watches day and night. I go to him in prayer. He knows my every care. And just a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about our troubles.
He will
hear our faintest cry.
He will
answer by and by. Feel a little prayer will turn
you. We
know a little fire is burning. Find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Find a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
A call comes ringing o'er the restless waves.
Send the light,
send the light,
send the light,
send the light. There are souls to rescue, there are souls to save.
Send the light,
send the light,
send the light,
send the light.
We will spread,
we will spread
the everlasting
light
with the will,
with the will,
heart in hand,
heart in hand,
giving God.
Evermore,
we will follow,
we will follow
His command.
Send the light,
send the light,
the blessed gospel light.
Let it shine,
let it shine,
from shore to shore,
from shore to shore.
Send the light,
send the light,
and let it
radiate, it beams
like the world,
like the world,
forevermore,
We have heard the Macedonian call today.
Send the light,
send the light,
send the light,
send the light. And a golden offering at the cross we lay.
Send the light,
send the light,
send the light,
send the light.
We will spread,
we will spread
the everlasting
light
with the will,
with the will,
heart in hand,
heart in hand.
Giving God,
giving God
the glory evermore.
We will follow,
we will His command,
follow His command.
Send the light,
send the light,
the blessed gospel light.
Let it shine,
let it shine,
from shore to shore,
from shore to shore.
Send the light,
send the light,
and let it shine,
shine, it beams
like the world,
like the world,
forevermore,
forevermore.
Let us pray that grace may everywhere abound.
Send the light,
send the light,
send the light,
send the light. And the Christ-like spirit everywhere be found.
Send the light,
send the light,
send the light,
send the light.
we will spread
the everlasting
light
with the willing heart and hand,
giving God the glory evermore.
We will follow His command.
Let it shine from shore to shore.
Send the light and let it shine, beams like the world forevermore.
Let us not grow weary in the work of love.
Send the light.
Let us gather jewels for a crown above.
Send the light.
We will spread the everlasting light.
With the willing heart and hand.
Giving God the glory evermore.
We will follow His command.
Send the light, the blessed gospel light.
Let it shine from shore to shore.
Send the light and let it change, beams like the world forevermore.
There's no other name so sweet as Jesus. No one ever cares so much for me as to shed His precious blood to save me. No one ever cared so much for me.
When I'll see Him face to face up in glory, I will marvel at His nail-scarred feet. And I'll thank Him for the pain He suffered, because
He cared so much for me.
Soul, the wheels are rolling, red big wheel, turning on. well is it your soul? The wheels are rolling, way in the middle of the air.
Good morning, Ruth. I know you weren't ready. Let's start again. Good morning, Ruth. Happy Sabbath. That sounds so much better. I wish you were standing here because you look like a well-watered garden. Your faces are brilliant. The smiles behind the masks are welcoming. I see some daisies over here, some dandelions. I see some roses over here, and I also see some flowers that I don't know what their names are. We have some lovely visitors among us this morning, and I'm going to ask you just to stand. If you don't feel comfortable standing, because we know how it is, you can raise your hand. We want to give you that warm, warm, warm Ruth welcome. Will you stand with me, visitors? Oh, welcome to Ruth. Welcome to Ruth. You may be seated. And those who are watching us virtually, I really want you to get jealous. Come on down to Ruth. Let us have the fellowship of the Holy Spirit today. Let us join hands. It's a long time we haven't seen each other, right? We are together again to praise the Lord. We know that something good is going to happen. Something good is in store. So come on. Welcome to Ruth this morning. It's the best place that you could be. I want to invite my praise team as we raise our voices lustily in singing, "All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name." Amen.
Good morning and happy Sabbath, church, and to everybody who's visiting online. I'm asking for all of us to please stand for the opening hymn, number 229, "All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name."
Father in heaven, we are so thankful to you for another Sabbath day, a day of rest and gladness, a day of joy and light. We thank you, dear Father, we can come into your house to worship you today. May our worship, Father, be accepted in your sight. May you truly be honored, Father, as we declare that there is truly no God like Jehovah. Bless our worship now to your name's honor and glory. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. Please be seated. Well, it's so good to see you this morning. I trust that you are just glad to be in the house of God today. It's a little warm. We're trying to see if we can get the AC sorted out, but you just have to enjoy a warm welcome today. And hopefully by next week we can get it sorted. And I'm not sure what happened, but at least we know summer is on its way. Some places where we come from, we don't have AC. So just fan yourself, and I'm just wiping myself down too. But a few notices. Please pray for our members at Camp Friender. They're having a good time, I'm told. Everyone has arrived safely, and we thank God that they're having church out there in the wild. So please keep them in prayer. 21 days of prayer and fasting. We've been engaged in that for the past almost 21 days. It concludes this Friday evening. So therefore, we're asking everyone to tune in online for a Zoom Vespers, as we bring the curtains down to this 21 days of prayer and fasting in light of the series which Brother Robert will talk about in a little while. So I want you to please join us 7 o'clock Friday evening for Vespers as we close the 21 days of prayer and fasting. By the way, our ABC, that's our Adventist bookstore, will be coming to us. In June. So I want you to know that you can prepare to get your stuff. You can pre-order. We'll give you more information. In fact, if you look on the board on the outside, you will see the schedule on the board. So we're asking you to please support ABC when they come. All right? They will bring whatever you order, they will bring for you. If not, you just have to at least buy what they have. I want to certainly thank those who were able to support Sister Petra Lowe as she funeralized her mother-in-law yesterday. It was a wonderful service, a beautiful celebration of life yesterday. I want to also let you know that the funeral for Sister Louisa Gordon, that one of our members, she passed away a couple weeks ago. The funeral will be on Monday, the 23rd. We know it's a holiday, but it's just a church service here because the body will be taken back to Jamaica. So we're asking as many as possible to support, especially our seniors. Sister Gordon's funeral, 11 o'clock here on the 23rd, that's Monday of May. And those who knew Sister Alma Nesbeth, prominent name in our church, she passed away, and her funeral will be at the Perth Church this Monday, that's the 16th, at 11 o'clock. So please, if you can support the family, please do that. There will be no Bible class today, so you have a free afternoon with your family and to go and enjoy nature. So this afternoon, no Bible class, or if you are brave enough and adventurous enough, you can drive to Camp Friender and spend the evening there with the folks if you are that adventurous, like I'm going to do. But I'm going to stay overnight. I don't know about you. And because of Friender, there will be also no beginner's Bible class. So please let those who would normally join our Bible class on Wednesday and Sunday evening at 6:30 that there is no beginner's Bible class. However, though, The intergenerational chorale will meet this afternoon at 4 o'clock. So if you would like to join the chorale, well, if you have not been joining, Sister Faye, is it too late to join? It's last week. So if you can catch it quick, then you can be here, but if you have not come before. But those who have been coming, please come for the final session this afternoon at 4 o'clock. While Brother Robertson is coming, Roberts, please come. You'll see as you came in some plants on the outside. Now, this is in support of the Hope Prevails Foundation by Elder Thompson and Sheldon, his brother, in honor of their mother, they have a foundation. And so, if you see some plants that you like, the veg plants, all different kinds of vegetables, you may take what you want, write them down, and tell Ella Thompson what you took. Hello, it's Sabbath, so you can't steal on Sabbath. But they are 350 each, right? Each tray, as it were. So please note that, and I hope that we can support the Hope Prevails Foundation.
Morning, Church.
Okay, wait. Yeah.
My task today is to promote our spring lay evangelistic series. As is customary, firstly, I am the leader of the personal ministries department, and our thrust is evangelism. And so, yearly in the spring and fall, we have an evangelistic series. Now, quite coincidentally, this year, the presenters are here at the moment, and I'd like to ask them to stand at the moment, the other presenters. Sister Miller, Elder Miller, Elder
Fowler.
Elder Fowler, and Sister Gifty. Thank you. And so, and yours truly, I'm a part of that. Now, this starts next Sabbath, and that will be our first presentation, Saturday morning, Saturday evening, Sunday evening, Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, and right through to June the 4th. We don't have many of these. However, it will be on social media, on YouTube, Facebook, right? Mm-hmm. Instagram as well. That's what I'm told. So this year, we didn't really print a lot of these because generally people are all on social media. However, one of the reasons we left that out was because it's a in-person series. So we were inviting you to attend. Come in person. Come in large numbers. Bring your friends and family, and as you notice, our COVID protocols are pretty strict here. So everyone will be secure. Everyone will be safe. Jesus told the disciples, he said, all power is given to you. Go ye and baptize. Go ye and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, teaching them. And lo, I am with you always. And so we are encouraged to go out. If you don't go, there's no blessing. And with that in mind, I'm asking those of us who are able to come back. I'm not going anywhere. But after 2, I think about 2:30, we'll be going to the community. We just have just a few. So just a few members that are able to make it. We'll be standing right there, walk with comfortable shoes. And we will go into the surrounding community, right around the church area here, to let them know what's going on. As you notice that we don't have a sign out front, and that's one of the reasons why we need to inform our neighbors what's going on in the area. We are hoping that the church will support us. As is customary, this is a church program. And so, as a member of the church, we're expecting you to attend. And if you can't attend, then you would visit with us on social media, but we are hoping that you would not visit with your fingers, but visit with your body, come in person. That's all I really have to say at the moment. You will not receive these on your way out because we really don't have many. That's the reason for the promotion, the in-person promotion. So thanks for listening. Look forward to seeing you all. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. In fact, you know, I drove up here a couple of days ago, and somebody was trying to open the church door to come in. And I said, oh, everything okay? He said, oh, I can't believe the bank is closed so early. I said, well, this is not the bank. This is the church. The bank is across there, but you're welcome to deposit some money here. Yeah. So I said, well, I have to go and get it first. So we do need a sign, by the way. So there you go. Before Sister Carol comes to us, I want to let you know that later on, he's not here yet, but he's actually here. Pastor, good to see you. Our speaker for today is Pastor Carl Michael Angelo Cunningham. The length of a name does not represent the length of his sermon. He's the associate pastor for the Mississauga Seventh-day Adventist Church. He's a dynamic speaker and preacher. He's a skilled musician. And so if we had problems today, he can jump on any one of these instruments and make music. He's an engaging educator and a personable mentor. His passion for life is to fulfill his divine calling to serve humanity with his gifts and talents. He enjoys exploring new places, adventures in nature, sports, and live music. I've been very privileged to work with Pastor Cunningham in the Metro West District, and I can always depend on him to support and also to be innovative in his thinking. And I want to say we are just blessed to have him as our speaker today. So please pray for him that when he comes up later on, that his message will truly challenge us to a life of service, especially as we embark on our series. Pastor Cunningham is happily married to his college sweetheart, Vanessa. And Vanessa is a mental health therapist. And she's also a very powerful speaker and psychoeducator. So we're very happy to have this couple with us. And I know that God will bless their ministry to us today. And you will want him to come back. So please prepare your hearts for the message for later on. At this time, I'm going to invite Sir Carl to come forward and do our second readings and also introduce our babies for dedication.
Good morning, church. Happy Sabbath. It's good to be into the house of the Lord once more. Before the baby dedication, I just have a couple of membership transfers to read. And this is the first reading for Jennifer Jackson from the Ruth Seventh-day Adventist, for Jennifer Jackson from the Ruth Seventh-day Adventist Church to the St. Thomas Seventh-day Adventist Church. The second one is Roger Lennon from the Flamstead Garden Seventh-day Adventist Church in Jamaica to Ruth Seventh-day Adventist Church. And Carice Buckner Lennon from the Shiloh Seventh-day Adventist Church in St. Elizabeth, Jamaica to the Ruth Seventh-day Adventist Church. This is the first reading for these three individuals. We will now move into our baby dedication service. Parents, when I call your name, I ask you to come to the platform. You will stand to my left and to my right. Grandparents, and if there are any siblings of the baby, can come to the platform also. The first one is Hermani Arabella Hogart, born on December 24th, 2021, weighing 5 pounds, 8 ounces, at the Mount Sinai Hospital.
parents are Erman Hogarth and Raquel Sterling. Second one is Amaya Perrin, born on April 4th, 2020, weighing 7 pounds 11 ounces at the Umber River Regional Hospital. Parents are Mark Perrin and Mecca Bernard.
Well, it's so good to welcome these families today for this important service of dedication for your special bundle of joy. So I want to certainly welcome Herman and Raquel. And we praise God for your little one, Hermione. And we thank God for her safe arrival, and you have with you godparents and the other family member. That's God over there. Okay. Good to have you all. Good to have you all. And of course, we have over here Mark and Mecca. We praise God as we bring, Amaya? Amaya of dedication. And you have certainly a stalwart grandmother standing beside you, one of our elders in this church. I want you to think very carefully about the assignment that God has given to you, Herman and Raquel, to care for Amani, and Mark and Mecca to care for Amaya. What an assignment. What an assignment in this day and age when children are in such danger. I say danger because we hear so much today of how children are treated or mistreated, and ill-treated. But when God says to you, Herman and Raquel, Mark and Mecca, God says to you in Proverbs 22 and verse 6, he says to train up your child. Train up Amaya, train up Hermione. In the way that he or she would go, and in this case, she would go. And when he's old, and when she's old, she will not depart from it. You know, if you're going to build a building and you want to take shortcuts, do not take shortcuts with the foundation. It's okay if you want to put some substandard 2x4s and so forth. I'm not saying you should, but you may get away with that. But you won't get away with substandard foundation. That's what the Bible says. You must train up Hermione and train up Amaya in the way that she should go. Which way should she go? She should go in the way of the Lord, in the way that God has instructed you to guide this child. You know, parents, you got to teach your child to be obedient. You know, sometimes I've seen parents they will give an instruction to a child, please do this. And the child will say, I'm not doing it. And the parent just leave the child. Okay, well, she doesn't want to do it. Really? That's training. No, you must teach the child to be obedient. Teach a child to follow instructions, no doubt godly instructions that you will give this child. And I want to say to you that if you want to, your child to go in the right way, then you learn from the Lord. You spend some time in His Word, and He will instruct you as the way that this child should go. I want to say to you that, above all, be there for your child. As I say, the child is not just for Christmas. It's a lifetime assignment. Although you have grandmother here, you have godparents here and other supporters, I want to say to you, it's good to have them, but no one can replace you, Herman. And no one can replace you, Raquel. No one can replace you, Mark and Mecca. No one can replace you. And God will say of you, because, you know, God always, you know, will call us to account. He will say to you, what did you do with Hermione? What did you do with Amaya? Did you instruct this child in the word of the Lord? Did you bring this child to the service of a church that she will learn of Jesus? How did you make the foundation stable? My prayer is that you will say to the Lord that, well, I did my best. I read to her from your word every night. I did my best. I brought her to the service of a church that she will know of you. I did my best. I surrounded her with good influences. I did my best. I gave her good counsel and direction. And God will say of you, well done. Well done, Herman. Well done, Raquel. Well done, Mark and Mecca. Well done. And because you have been faithful in carrying out this responsibility, God says, I will make you ruler over many things. And so because you have come today to dedicate this child to the Lord, I want to ask you, therefore, make some pledges as parents that you will certainly do all in your power to raise these children to the honor and glory of God. And so to Mark and to Raquel and to Mark and Mecca and to Raquel and Herman, I want to ask you today, since it's your intention to present Hermione and Maya dedication, do you here today recognize your child as a gift of God? And do you give heartfelt thanks for his blessing? Yeah? Amen. Do you here today wish to dedicate your child to the Lord who gave this child to you? Do you here this day pledge as parents that you will use home, school, and church and every other means available in helping your child to learn to love Jesus? And to the godparents and to the church, do you promise to support these parents through your prayers, church programs, and a nurturing church atmosphere? Do you promise to do that, church? What about over here? Amen. What about the rest of the family? What about the godparents? That's a little weak. Yeah. The Bible says that the parents brought young children to Jesus that he would touch them. And his disciples rebuked those who brought the children. But Jesus said, suffer the little children. In other words, do not prevent the little children from coming to me. For such is the kingdom of God. And the Bible says, he took up in his arms, he placed his hands upon them, and he blessed them. Since COVID has come, we don't take the babies anymore. But we're going to offer now a special prayer of dedication on their lives. And so I ask now that parents, you just, and everyone here, just bow your heads reverently as we talk to the Lord in prayer.
great God, our Father in heaven, we stand reverently in your presence this morning. We stand there, Lord, as your children, and we thank you so much for health and for strength, for even the ability to walk through these doors, to come into this your house today. We come, Lord, because you said in your word that we should come boldly to your throne of grace. But these parents come, and they come there, Lord, today with their children, Herman and Raquel. They have brought to you, Lord, Hermione. And they're asking their God for a special blessing upon her life. They're asking their Lord that you will shield this child from harm and from danger. They're asking their Lord that you will place your hand upon Hermione and that you will bless her today. But it's also Mark and Mecca, Father, they've come. And they have brought Amaya, this bond of joy you have entrusted to them. And they've come, Lord, also, asking that you will bless their child, that you will bless Amaya, that you will keep her, Lord, in your care. And I pray, dear Father, today, that you will answer their prayer. But more importantly, Father, I want to present these parents to you. I want to present Herman and Raquel, Mark and Mecca to you, Father, these parents, because you have entrusted these children to them. I pray that you'll give them patience, that you'll give them health and strength, that you'll give them the means so they can care for these children, that you'll give them a heart like yours to love Hermione and to love Amaya. I pray, dear Father, today, that these parents will always make time for their children. Doesn't matter how busy life gets. And I pray, Lord, that you will reward them for their faithfulness. And so, Lord, I pray you'll put a shield around Hermione and Amaya today. I pray, Lord, that you will give them sound minds. They will not only comprehend the things of this world, but they'll comprehend the things of God. They'll have a desire for your word, a desire for you, Father, because their parents will teach them about you. I pray, Father, that you will help these children to grow up, dear Lord, to be a credit to you, that they will declare your praises, but also, Lord Jesus, bring joy to the heart of their parents. I ask, dear Father, that the plans that you have for Amani and the plans that you have for Maya will be fulfilled in their lives, and they, Father, will live out the purpose for which you have created them. And so today, Father, I ask that you will truly set these children apart, put an edge around them, keep them from the wiles of the enemy, keep them from those who will hurt, harm, and destroy, that you will send angels that excel in strength that will always, Father, protect them. I pray, God, that you will surround these, your children now, with your divine care as a hen will gather her chicks under her wing. And so, Lord, I pray now that you will bless Hermione and Amaya and keep them. That you'll make your face, Father, shine upon them. And that you'll be gracious unto them. That you'll lift the light of your countenance upon them. And you'll grant them your peace. We dedicate them today now. In the name of God the Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, his Son. In the name of the Holy Spirit, the Comforter. And everyone say, amen, amen, and amen, amen. Amen. God bless you as you raise these children. For him, we're going to invite our nurture department to come and give you your certificates of dedication. And also a little gift for the children. God bless you. Okay.
bless everyone. Make God proud by raising these children to his honor and his glory. I think we have Sister Jennifer Lewis Phillips in the house. So please come now and give to us our children's story for today.
Good morning, church. A special good morning to our children. And to those who are watching us from home, a very special welcome to you as well. So we always tell stories about other children, but we're going to be talking about our children today. We're going to be talking about Amaya. We're going to be talking about Jason. We're going to be talking about Jacob. All our children within our church and those who are watching from home. So I am going to talk about when God made you. You. When God made you, God made you all shiny and new. An incredible you. A you all your own. A you unlike anyone else ever known. An exclusive design, one God divine. You're a perfectly crafted one of a kind. 'Cause when God made you, somehow God knew that the world needed someone exactly like you. You, God thinks about you. God was thinking of you long before your debut. From the very beginning, amid history and time, you, little one, never left God's mind. God imagined your eyes, your head's shape and size, and knew what you would look like when you felt surprised. God pictured your nose and all 10 of your little toes. The sound of your voice, just like mine, God had it composed. The lines on your hands, your hair, every strand, God knew every detail like it was all planned. Out of billions of faces from cultures, all races, people God made from all different places, God knew your name. Your picture is framed. God's family without you would not be the same. 'Cause when God made you, this is true. The world got to meet who God already knew. You. When God see you, God delights in what is and sees only what's true. That you, yes, you, in all of your glory, bring color and rhythm and rhyme to God's story. So, be you, fully you, a show-stopping review. Live your life in full color, every tint, every hue. Discover, explore, have faith, but love more. And learn and relearn that God made you for. Use your talents and passions, those gifts that God fashioned. Think up ideas and then put them to action. 'Cause God loves you creating, your true self displaying, when light on the inside through art is portraying. When you make believe, the stories conceive, the heroics, the magic, those tricks up your sleeve. When you dance alone, spinning like a cyclone, being whoever, whatever in a world all your own, God smiles, and here's why. In the spark of your eye, a familiar reflection shines bright from inside. Cause when God made you and the world oohed and ahed, in heaven they called you an image of God. You, when God dreams about you, God dreams about all that in you will be true. That you, God's you, will be hopeful and kind, a giver who lives with all heart, soul, and mind. A dreamer who dreams in big and small themes, one who keeps dreaming in journeys upstream. A mover, a shaker, a lover of nature, a builder of bridges, you, the peacemaker. And you who views others as sisters and brothers and lives by these three words, love one another. A confident you, strong and brave too. You, being you, is God's dream coming true. Because when God made you, all of heaven was beaming over you. God was smiling and already dreaming. In Genesis 1, verses 27 and 28, so God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. And God blessed them. So, for the children who didn't know, me and you have a special relationship with God. You also have a special relationship with your parents because you could only be the person who God could place in that family. So when your friends tell you otherwise, let them know, I am special because God made me and he said so. Let us pray for our children. Father, we just thank you for the day you have given us to come and to praise your name and to bless you. We ask, Lord, that you'd be with our children. And as we teach them from day to day, Lord, may your words be written upon their hearts. And may you give their parents patience and confidence to instill in them all the things that are like you, so that they might be stalwarts standing up for you. And finally, Lord, help us that we might be able to stand with our children when you shall come and save us in your kingdom, we pray, in Jesus' worthy name. Amen.
It is now time for us to return our tithe and a free will offering to the Lord. Now, as Bible-believing Christians, we honor God by returning 1/10 of our gross earnings to him and a free will offering. Free will, that means any amount you want to give to the Lord after you have returned your faithful tithe. There are two boxes here. We're going to ask you to come forward and place your gifts that you brought for the Lord in these two boxes. Now, because we worship both physically and virtually, there are several ways that you can return your tithe and give a free will offering. You can always come here on Wednesday evenings at 4:30. There is a drop-off. And you can go to the Adventist Giving app. Whatever device you have, whether it be an Apple device or an Android, you can go to the app AdventistGiving.org. You can return your tithe there. Our church website also provides for e-transfer and donation. You can also do an e-transfer to Ruth Treasurer at AdventistOntario.org. And all of those ways of giving are on the screen. So I'm now going to invite you, after I pray, to come forward and place your gifts in the boxes that you brought for Jesus today. Father in heaven, it is indeed a privilege, Lord, to know that you have placed us in this position where we can give back to you. You gave your all for us. And so, Lord, as we bring our tithe and our offering today, we pray that you will bless it to the furtherance of your work. May you help us to remember that in all our giving, we should give our hearts totally surrendered to you. May you help us to recognize, Lord, that you are the King of Kings. You are the Lord of Lords. The earth is yours and the fullness thereof. Help us, dear Lord, then to honor you faithfully with the gifts that you have given us. We ask his mercies in Jesus' name. Amen. You're now free to bring your offering and put it in the boxes provided.
Morning, church. Come on. Look at the weather through the window. Don't you like the weather? Don't you like how it feels? So why not give God some praise and some glory? Amen. I love this. This is my kind of weather. At this time, it's time to give God thanks for bringing us through this week. For giving us the strength to tell the devil, take a walking leap. So, as we listen for the song this morning, let's put ourselves in an attitude of prayer so that we can praise the Lord. Father and our God, Jesus, our friend, our Redeemer,
Holy Spirit, our guide and our comforter. This morning, we want to give you all the glory and all the praise. Because, Lord, who then is there that we can praise? Who then is there that we can give glory but unto you? You said in your word that you make man to worship you. And Lord, we have come such a far way. We worship all your creation instead of the Creator. Father, Jesus, Holy Spirit, we ask for your forgiveness as we come bowing before your mercy seat this morning. Because without you, we are absolutely nothing. We are just like a leaf that is falling off the tree onto the ground and to decay. But thank God, as we have listened to the children's story this morning, that we were made in the image of God. We were made to worship you. And Father, we thank you, because without you, we are absolute nothing. All our righteousness then is even filthy rags. But Lord, you have given us the hope, and that is the hope of glory. That when you come, if you find us in the position that you want us to be in, we can go home and live with you eternally. Lord, when we see what's taking place in the world today, our heart is failing for fear and what is taking place. Because as you said in your word, that wicked men, they go to lie in their bed at night and they devise evil of how to get rid of your people. And in the daytime when they wake up, they do what they thought about in the night. But we have a comforter. We have a guide. We have a God that will take care of us. We only have to come to you, O God, with open hearts and a clear mind, and ask for your protection. And you promise to protect us. God, when we think of the children of Israel that was leaving Egypt, when they reached the Red Sea, they're looking forward. There was no hope for them. They're looking backward. The only hope there was to go back to Egypt. But Jesus, you blew with your nostril and a way was made clear. You are a God of miracles. And indeed, you have performed many miracles in our life. Lord, every one of us in this building, online, have a testimony to give of how you have saved them from many disasters, and how you have taken care of the enemies, that even sometimes they have to come back and ask, how did you do it? We didn't do it. The God of heaven did it. So Father, we come this morning to give you all the thanks and all the praise and all the glory. And as we're coming into your house this morning, Father, We just ask that our heart will be lifted up, that as we sing songs to you, it will not only fall in from the roof, but it will be our protection. The prayers we praise, the scriptures that we read, it's a weapon against the enemy. Thank you, Jesus. Because we only have to hold up that Bible and say, thus saith the Lord, and we have nothing to fear. So Lord, we just ask that you will continue to be in this house. We can ask that you continue to be with those online also, those who are listening, those who do not know you. Lord, a revival crusade is coming up, and we are ready, Father, to do the job. So I pray, oh God, that hearts will be made holy, so that when the knock come on the door, they will not just peep through the window, but they will open the door and invite you to come in. So Lord, we just leave this service into your hand. We thank you for every soul that is in this building today. We thank you for the weather. Lord, we thank you for the weather. Father, we thank you for the musicians. We thank you for the person that you have called to teach us your word today. And may our hearts be open and in full understanding of what you are trying to tell us. So that, God, this world will not just pass through one ear to the other, but it will deep down in our hearts and in our minds rest assured there that we can call upon you anytime, because you never slumber or you never sleep. So we just want to thank you. We just want to praise you, Lord. And we don't forget those who are not in the building today. They are at another place up in Frenda. And may they too enjoy the day there as we are enjoying it here. Because your Holy Spirit promised to be wherever you are invited. So we just want to thank you. We just want to praise you. We just want to lift you up on high. And as we continue in this service, when we shall leave this place, we would say without a doubt, it was good for us to have been in the presence and the house of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for hearing. Thank you for answering. We ask in your name, amen and amen.
Happy Sabbath and good afternoon, church. Are you guys happy to be in the house of the Lord today? If you are, clap your hands, praise him, give him some praise. Like we have mentioned before, the weather is nice outside, so that means our spirits are starting to warm up as well as outside. So today, our first song is going to be What a Friend We Have in Jesus. Through our good days, through our bad days, through our worst days, he's always there for us. So we're gonna start with What a Friend We Have in Jesus.
What
privilege it is to carry everything to God in prayer. What a friend, what a friend we have in Jesus. All of our sins,
all our sins and griefs to bear. Righteous. He's here for us in everything that we do, everything we think, and everything that we say. So today we're going to be introducing a new song called God Almighty. So just sing along and hope that the Spirit is with you guys as we move and we sing.
Ooh.
Say, God Almighty, Lord of glory, Lord, we worship you. Everybody say, God Almighty, Lord of glory, Lord, we worship you.
Oh, what you ask me to. I want to go wherever you say. Say the word and I'll obey. I want to live a life that's real. I want to serve you, Lord, for real. For you deserve all this and more. So I give you every little thing that I have and more. It belongs to you. I give you every little thing that I need and more. Say hey, I want to give my best to you. I want to do what you ask me to. I want to go wherever you say.
Say the word.
Say the word and I will obey. I want to live a life that's real. I want to serve you, Lord, for real. For you deserve all this and more. So I give you every little thing that I have and more. It belongs to you. I give you every little thing that I need and more.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, saints. Hallelujah in God's house. Isn't it good to be in the house of the Lord on the Sabbath day? This is the day that God has made. We will rejoice. We will clap our hands. We will stomp our feet and we will praise the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be on my tongue. The righteous shall hear thereof and be, oh, magnify the Lord with me. Ruth, won't you magnify the Lord with me? And let us exalt his name together. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We bless the Lord. The psalmist says, the angel of the Lord encamps around those that fear him and delivereth them. And then he says, oh, taste and see. Oh, Ruth, won't you taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man and the woman that put their trust in him. And so we bless the Lord at all times. We praise him continually. His praise shall always be on our tongues. Praise ye the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him on the high sounding cymbals. And praise him on the stringed instruments. Let everything that hath breath praise ye the Lord. Oh, won't you praise him? Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Jesus, blessed Savior, he's worthy to. Sing it with me. To praise a little. The sun is out and there is sunshine in my soul. It's good to be in the house of the Lord on the Sabbath day. There's no better place to be. If you love Jesus, won't you say amen? If Jesus loves you, say praise the Lord. And if he's coming again for you, say hallelujah. Yes, he is. Hallelujah. I bring you greetings from the brethren over at Mississauga, your sister church, from our senior pastor, Pastor Mark Ewan, and my family too. I apologize, my wife was not able to be with us here this Sabbath morning. I think she's watching online. And I'd like to thank your pastor, Uncle Bishop Dr. Nerval Myrie. You have a visionary leader and pastor. And please continue to pray for him and support him as he leads the saints in this part of the vineyard. And I bring greetings also to and express my gratitude to my brother, Pastor Andrew Thomas. But this moment is not about me. We have a word from the Lord. Can somebody say hallelujah to that? And so I'd like to direct you to Acts chapter 16. Acts chapter 16, you may have brought your Bible in print or a digital copy to church. Open it up, turn it on. Acts chapter 16, I'll read it in your hearing for the sake of time. I'll go from verse 16 just to give you some context of the story. It says from verse 16, "Now it happened as we went to prayer that a certain slave girl possessed with a spirit of divination met us. She brought her masters much profit by fortune telling. This girl followed Paul and us and cried out saying, 'These men are the servants of the Most High God who proclaimed to us the way of salvation,' and this she did for many days. But Paul, being greatly annoyed, turned and said to the Spirit, 'I command you in the name of Jesus to come out of her.' And he came out at that very hour." Hallelujah. "But when her masters saw that their hope of profit was gone, they seized Paul and Silas, dragged them into the marketplace to the authorities. And they brought them to the magistrates and said, 'These men being Jews, these Seventh-day Adventist Christians, they are exceedingly troubling our city. And they teach customs which are not lawful according to the laws of the land,'" if I may paraphrase. Verse 22 says, "The multitude arose, they gathered together against them, and the magistrates tore off their clothes, beat them with rods. And when they had laid many stripes on them, they threw them into the prison, commanding the jailer to keep them secure. Having received such a charge, he put them into the inner prison and fastened their feet to the stocks." Verse 25 says, "But at midnight," mighty God, "Silas and Paul were praying and singing hymns to God, and the prisoners were listening to them. Suddenly," how soon? "Suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken. And immediately," how soon? "Immediately all the doors were open and everyone's chains were loose." That was your shout cue, youth. I'd like to speak to you from this passage of scripture under the caption, "Midnight Praise." Midnight Praise. Almighty God, one more time, remove me. Speak to your people. Speak through me. And may your people receive your word. In the name of Jesus, amen. Amen. When I was a younger boy, you know, I'm a man now. I could say that I'm coming up in age. But when I was a younger man, a young boy coming up, I would go to a summer camp in the summertime. It's a good time. You get to fellowship with believers and saints from across the conference. We'd all end up at summer camp. We'd have a good time. When it was time to leave, everybody would be bawling and shedding tears because the bonds that we formed there were so precious. Anybody could relate. So at summer camp, they would divide us into units. And one of the responsibilities of each unit would be to be on kitchen duty. So you'd be washing the pots. Sometimes you'd be put on security duty. So you would be custodians for the entire campgrounds. And when you're on security duty, sometimes you would have the night shift. Now, at the night shift, you get sleepy. Can somebody relate? Because they work night shift. You get sleepy, you get tired, and it's the most difficult shift to keep watch. When it gets to about midnight, you really start to feel the pressure of sleep clouding down on your life, clouding down on your body, and you just want to put up everything, lay your head somewhere, and get some rest. But you can't rest because the security of the entire campground is at stake. You have a responsibility to ensure that everyone on the campground is safe. So you can't rest. You must press on through the night. And you must also know that the brightest morning comes just before the darkest night. And so sometimes we find ourselves in a midnight experience in our lives. It's hard to lift up praise to God when things aren't going your way, when things seem to be stacked against you. During the dark and bleak times of your life, when the clouds of doubt seem to hover over your life and you can't see the sunlight piercing through, it seems like God is either sleeping or he does not care when you're praying your prayers at midnight. And you say, Lord, why should I continue to send up praise? Why should I continue to pray when it seems the blessings aren't coming down during the midnights of your life? A midnight represents those times when you can't see where to go or how you will move forward. Midnight is when you're at your wits' end with school. Hello, somebody. Midnight is when you're stuck in a job you hate and you can't resign. You can't quit it because you've got to pay the bills. Midnight is when you've been to a therapist, you've got the medication, you're struggling through the highs and lows of depression, but you can't seem to catch a break. Midnight is when your health's failing. I'm preaching to somebody today. You're doing test after test, and the doctors don't know what's wrong. Midnight is when you can't make ends meet, and the bills are piling up. Midnight is when your children are wayward, and they're getting on your last nerve, and you want to beat them and send them to Jamaica. Midnight is when your spouse annoys you and your marriage is on the rocks. Midnight is when you've been fasting and praying, but God seems silent. It gets even worse. Midnight is when you're doing God's work, when you're fulfilling his mission and his purpose for your life, but it seems like the enemy just keeps piling up obstacles against you. It feels like midnight. Now, you ought to know, saints, that if you ever make up your mind to serve God, to do something for him, and not just for yourself, you can testify and witness that there are some obstacles that are going to come against you. But you ought to know that when you're on a divine mission, when you've set out to do right by God, that all hell is going to be pitted against you. So the psalmist David say, many they be that trouble me, many they be that rise up against me, but thou, O Lord, are a shield unto me, my glory, and the lifter up of my hand. You ought to remember that Jesus said during your midnight experiences that if the world hates you, know that it hated me too, because you are not of the world, but I have chosen you out of the world for a divine purpose. You ought to know that we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers and the rulers of darkness of this world. You ought to know that when the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will raise up a standard. So when you go through your midnights, you ought to cry out to Jesus. John says, greater is he that is in you than he that is within the world. It seems, saints, when you resolve to serve the Lord, the clouds of trouble immediately move from wherever they were and they begin to hover over your life. It's like those who are called to do the work of the Lord magnetize trouble. I can relate to this in a very personal way. You see, my dad was a pastor, is a pastor, and during times of evangelistic campaigns, it seems like there was some divine, some spiritual attack that we would always undergo as a family. Somebody would crash, would end up in some accident in the hospital. Something was being pitted against us, and we knew that it was not just by chance. It's principalities and powers, because we're about to do the work of God. And so you ought to know that when you're about to do the work of God, the enemy is going to send some traps your way. You see, God's people are not called to chill and sit passively on the side to be spectators. We are not called to sit in church pews and listen to good sermons and good singing and go home and fill our tummies on nice potluck. We are called to be more than that. We are not called to be missing in action on the gospel field. We are not called to be silent on issues affecting those who are weak and disenfranchised and marginalized and oppressed. Followers of Christ are called to be salt and light to fulfill and complete his mission in the world. And Jesus told us what our mission ought to be based on what his mission is. He was very clear. He says, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Why? Because he calls me to comfort the afflicted, to free the captives, and to set at liberty those who are oppressed. The people of God ought not to sit in pews and do nothing. And so, in this passage of scripture, we find that Paul and his buddy Silas, they are on a divine assignment. And how will we know that we have the Spirit of Jesus? You think we have the Spirit of Jesus when we sing nice and preach nice and we look well dapper on a Sabbath morning? That's not what the Spirit of Jesus is. The Spirit of Jesus is when you are doing the work of God on the battlefield for my Lord. We are called to be troublemakers. You see, I'm often disturbed by us being silent and people not knowing who we are. If we were troublemakers like Paul and Silas were troublemakers, then people would know who Seventh-day Adventists are. And in some ways, that causes us to be complicit and to perpetuate the injustices of the society because we don't want to offend anybody. But I've come to let you know, saints, that God calls us to speak out against injustice, against inequality and oppression. God's people are called to stand up and to speak out. We are called to do what is sometimes unpopular, unwelcome, despite the impending consequences. We are called to be troublemakers. And so Paul had received a call and vision to come over to Macedonia to help the gospel work in Philippi. This was an important colony of the Roman Empire. And Paul and Silas were spending some time at the family of a new convert woman entrepreneur called Lydia. She's a strong woman. She is a businesswoman, an entrepreneur. But as they were there, they went to pray, and a slave girl possessed with a spirit, the Bible says, brought her masters much profit. In other words, her masters were pimping this girl for profit. We're getting a little deeper into the story. Buckle your seatbelts. These men, she says, are the servants of the Most High God who proclaim to us the way of the Lord. Now, I had to pause here because they go into the city, and what we find is that they are preaching and teaching and healing, and there's this woman that is under a spirit of divination, and she's saying, these are the men of God. So why was the Apostle Paul troubled about this? Wasn't he a man of God? Well, you ought to know that sometimes in doing the work of God, our method matters. Let me say that again. Sometimes in doing the work of God, our method matters. Sometimes you've got to be discreet. Sometimes you've got to be silent as a dove, harmless as a dove, but roaring like a lion, because our God is the conquering lion of the tribe of Judah. And so Paul gets frustrated. He says, I command you, in the name of Jesus, to get out of her. And she came out at that very moment. You've got to understand, saints, that the authority that is given to us as followers of Christ is beyond what we can think or imagine. we need to stop walking around defeated, cowering in fear, living under our potential, living in timidity. We ought to be courageous for the gospel of Christ. What does Jesus say to Peter? I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. As a believer, you have spiritual authority. And so, when her masters saw that their hope of profit was gone, they seized Paul and Silas and dragged them into the marketplace, and they brought them to the magistrates and said, these men, being Jews, exceedingly trouble our city. These guys are troublemakers, and they are messing with our money. You ought to know that one thing the devil does not want is for you to mess with his money. Don't mess with his moolah. Don't mess with his cheddar. Because that's how the evil proliferates in the world. You know the old saying that says, money makes the world go round. But you ought to also know, saints, that the love of money is the root of all evil. I like money, but there's nothing to me like my Jesus. Because the cattle on a thousand hill belong to him. You want to see how evil is proliferated? Follow the money. It's money that funds and fuels organized crime in our cities. The transatlantic slave trade, the love of money. Jim Crow law and segregation, the love of money. Wars in the Middle East, the love of money, the love of oil money. Human trafficking and sex slavery, the love of money. The love of money is the root of all evil. Well, saints, the word of God, the work of God in the world is to bring people out of their situations of captivity, who are held captive by sin and the systems of the enemy. The thief cometh but to steal and to kill, but Jesus says, I come that people might have life and have it more abundantly. And so whom the Son sets free is free indeed. The story goes on. I know you're hungry, so I'll press on for the sake of time. Paul and Silas messed with these pimps' money. And so they seized them, brought them to the local authorities, accusing them of inciting anarchy, disorder, and lawlessness. They tore off their clothes, beat them, and put them in the inner prison. But the word of God says, but at midnight. No, church, that was your shout cue. But at midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the prisoners were listening to them. Are you hearing that? Suddenly, there was a great earthquake so that the very foundations of the prison were shaken. Immediately, all the doors were loosed and everyone's chains flung open. You see, the desire of the enemy, hear me, saints, is to mute and to muzzle our praise. Let me say that one more time. The enemy wants to mute and muzzle your praise, and so he sends these troubles in your lives and sets up persecution against the people of God because he wants to stifle and silence our praise. Some of us, it seems like the enemy has us in a chokehold. He wants to silence our praise. He wants to muzzle our praise. But in the hour of our deepest pain, when we are in the deepest dungeon, in the innermost prison, when the stocks and the chains have been bounded at our feet, it is then that we ought to make a joyful noise unto the Lord and to shout unto God with a voice of triumph. It is then that you ought not to lose your hope, don't lose your faith, and don't lose your praise. What you ought to know, and that sister said it that prayed so ably for us today. She says that what you ought to know is that praise confuses and confounds the enemy. The devil wants to mute you. He wants to muzzle your praise. He wants to keep you silent and stifled. But you ought to lift up your voice to God and praise him through your struggles. Say, devil, you can't take my job. Or devil, you may take my money. Devil, you could take my house. You could take my car. You could take my family. You may even afflict my health, but you can't ever take my praise. when the enemy comes at us, it is to distract us from all the powerful things that God has done in our past and is willing to do in our present and to do in our future. God is the only one who is able to deliver us from the situations in which we find ourselves. And so the enemy wants to keep you in guilt so you don't praise him. He wants to keep you in depression so you don't praise him. He wants to snatch your joy away. He wants to keep your head down, but lift up your eyes unto the hills from whence comes your help. Get this, somebody. You gotta get this. He knows that if he can keep you focused on your situation, on how small and powerless and insignificant you are in comparison to the obstacle that you're against, and if he can make you consider how formidable, how colossal, and how seemingly unsurmountable your problem is, then he knows he keeps you trapped. But you've got to remind him that the Word of God says, I can get through all things through Christ that strengthens me. And so when we begin to praise, God begins to move and chains begin to loose. Woo! Let's say that again. When we begin to praise, chains begin to loose and God begins to move. So as we go forward, get your pens. Amen. I like that. Get your pens, get your phone, open your notes app, and take these notes down. If you're on Instagram, tweet it. If you're on Twitter, tweet it. If you're on TikTok, you know what to do. Text it to somebody. The first is this, from this passage of Scripture. When you are on a mission for the Lord, expect trouble. You see, when you go on a mission for God, when you're doing good unto the least of these, my children, you've got to expect trouble. You've got to know that when you're on a divine assignment, the enemy is going to send trouble your way because he does not want you to bring deliverance to someone who is out there dying in sin. Expect trouble. The word says, suddenly there was a great earthquake so that the foundations of the prison were shaken. Though you're expecting trouble, you've got to know that God is going to show up. Ooh. God is going to show out. And he's going to show himself strong and mighty. So when we begin to praise, God begins to move and chains begin to loose. Expect trouble. And you've got to praise through your trouble. What do I mean? Well, you know, the other day if I could get a little closer to you, you may be able to relate to this. I got a bump on my leg, and it was so painful. You know, I just couldn't bear the pain. It was so painful, and so I had to ask my wife to squeeze it. It's a little gory, but hear me, I'm going somewhere. But you see, the only way that I could bear the pain is if I cried out and made a lot of noise. Sometimes when you're going through your pain, if you cry out to God and make a noise of shout and joyful noise unto the Lord, you ought to know that you will get through your pain. Gotta expect trouble. Number two is this. Though trouble rises up, be still and see the salvation of the Lord. Watch God work. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted, and my will be done in all the earth. Suddenly, there was a great earthquake because God began to move. And when God begins to move, he inhabits the praises of his people. And so you ought to know that when God moves into our little space, things begin to shake. We begin to feel the ground shaking, and you wonder what it is. It is the movement of God. He's an on-time God. Yes, he is. May not come when you want him, but he'll be there right on time. You've got to expect trouble, but watch God work through your trouble. Number three is this. You've got to know that your praise through your times of trouble, through midnight experiences, is a witness. The word says, they were shackled It was midnight, and they began to sing and give praises to God. And the prisoners heard them. Better yet, a better way of saying this is that not just they heard them, they heard them as in they listened to them. As in, when you go to a concert, you don't pay your money just to go and sit down and hear the music. You go and listen to your music because you want your money's worth. You ought to know that when you praise, somebody is not just hearing you, somebody is listening, and that your witness, your praise will be a testimony, and that is how they will overcome their struggle. Prisoners were listening and saying they ain't never heard no gospel music in a prison dungeon. And so for the most part, those vaults echoed only with curses and foul words. They only heard choice words in those prison halls. They'd never heard anybody praising through midnight. And the prisoners were listening to them. And you've got to know, saints, that somebody is listening. Somebody is being ministered to by your response to your troubles. Somebody is struggling with their faith and will be ministered to by your ministry. You've got to know that as you go through your situation, somebody is going to be encouraged in their situation by your praise. The word of God says they overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. So you've got to lift up praise to God. So I could hear them singing, if you're happy and you know it, say amen. How could I be happy through the midnight experience but sing anyway? I could hear them saying, we are soldiers in the army. We've got to fight. I could hear them saying, he's an on-time God. I could hear them saying, troubles don't last always. I could hear them saying, swing low, sweet chariot. I could hear them saying, every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. They never lost hope, they never lost faith, and they never lost praise. And so, saints, as you go through your troubles in life, I don't know what you're going through right now. I don't know what you're struggling through in your life right now. But you must know that all of us have our midnight. You may not be in yours right now, but know that somebody sitting in the pew beside you is going through a midnight experience. Some of us come to church and we can't smile because we're going through it. But don't forget to give God praise through your midnight. When we begin to move, when we begin to praise, God begins to move and chains begin to loose. And so I leave you with a psalmist David. Bless the Lord at all times. Keep his praise continually on your tongue. Make your soul boast in the Lord so that the humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, saints. And let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord. He heard me and delivered me through my midnight crucible. They looked unto him and were lightened. This poor man, this poor woman cried unto God. And he did hear us. Don't you ever lose your hope. Don't you never lose your faith. Don't you ever lose your praise.
Amen, folks. What a powerful sermon. The Spirit has been here today, and we're just going to allow him to continue to be with us through this closing hymn. So to God be the glory. Please stand as we sing.
Amen. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. It'd be amiss of me not to give someone who may be going through a midnight experience right now and felt the moving of the Holy Spirit in your life, calling you to give your life completely to God. It'd be amiss of me not to give you that opportunity. If there's someone who is watching online, send a message in the chat. Someone from Ruth's team will reach out to you. If there's someone in the congregation today, here is the calling of God on your life. Harden not your heart. You can come forward. You could raise your hand where you are. Let us pray. Almighty God and our Father, you're a good God. Blessed be your name. We thank you, Lord, for the opportunity we had to be in your presence today. And we pray, Lord, that as we disassemble and we go home and to our various places of abode, we pray, Lord, that your Spirit will remain with us. Give us a special outpouring of your presence, a special outpouring of your Spirit, so that we may truly be salt and light in our communities, at work, at home, at play. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Let the church say amen.
Church, say amen. Man, did we have church today? So let me hear you say praise the Lord. Thank you so much, Pastor Cunningham, for sharing with us today about that midnight. That midnight what? Midnight praise. And I recorded your takeaways. When you're on a mission for the Lord, expect trouble. Right now, this church is on a mission for the Lord. And that is why we're attacked minutely, hourly, and daily. But we know the God in whom we serve. It says, though trouble rises up, be still. You know, many times we get trouble and we want to defend ourselves immediately. But God says, be still and know that I am God. You have to know that your praise in your time of trouble is a witness. Bless the Lord at all times, because the angel of the Lord encamps around all who trust him, and he delivereth them. The last takeaway I had, if you ever make up your mind to serve the Lord, the enemy will pile up obstacles in front of you. So as you face this untried week, I want you to rely on these charges that Pastor Cunningham gave us today. And as you face the untried week, remember to be still, because God is God. I just have one late announcement. Church, we will be having in-person church come next Sabbath, the 21st of May. Parents, you're asked to bring all your children, because we will be having Sabbath school starting May 21 in church. Thank you. Have a blessed rest of the Sabbath.
I hope you've all been blessed throughout the day. Now we are going to be having after praise, and our song will be Hello.
You are welcome in this place, oh God. I'm afraid.
Sabbath, everybody.
Thank you. Come on, y'all, make some noise. Make some noise, make some noise, make some noise. Come on, make some noise out there. Here we go. I was young.
I was young.
Thank you.
Yeah. come away.